is burning up in the dark. I know you're feeling the heat. Yeah, I know you feel the rush. Black snap back, black be me. I'm a chain so bright they can see me. I do it how they see me do it on the TV. But you just ain't looking the same in 3D. You're living a lie, I'm living a dream. Table full of champagne, chilling with the queen. Raise the sharp blade, I'm a guillotine. Soon as I get ahead, I'm bringing a team. BBK, I'm bringing the team. 100% UK, we're killing the scene. Now they're hooked on the sound like it's nicotine. Got their arms stretched out like a limousine. I got my shades on, tell them I still see them. Tell them I hate as I wouldn't want to be them. My team's strong like the bricks in the Coliseum. Yeah. So let's make peace, not war. I see girls from all over the world on the floor. So the DJ replay, give me more. The DJ replay, give me more. So let's make peace, not war. I see girls from all over the world on the floor. So the DJ replay, give me more. Bad karaoke and good melodies, bad hangovers and good memories. But right now, I'ma do it how I say I do it. I'ma jump that hurdle when I get to it. I'm looking at her, looking at me. I'm the gingerbread man, come and catch me. Talk of the town, you could be my TT. A housemate in my celebrity BB. You looking like a star, where's your manager? 10 out of 10 from the front, now back it up. These other guys just ain't got the stamina. Me, I rock and roll like Noel Gallagher. So why they hating on the king for? Huh? So why they hating on the king for? I'm just living my life, better live yours. Shit, so let's make peace, not war.
Yes, good evening there. Welcome to the Leicester City Fan Zone Show. My name's Phil and it's Monday night, it's 7:30. We are very lucky tonight. We have got Neil Danns, ex-Leicester City player, joining us live in just a couple of moments' time. Get your questions in, get your comments in. Whatever you want to ask Neil Danns, you can do it because this is your Leicester City, Leicester Fan TV Fan Zone Show. All right, let's start with a few hellos. Hi to Maz. Thanks for watching tonight. Please like and share, Maz. Lewis wants to ask, how was his time at Bury? Matthew Bond is watching. Good evening to you. So Sean Sarson, very, very good evening to you. Graham Ball, Mark Charles saying good evening from all you fellow Foxes. Lee Shaw and Mick Bell. How are you, Mick? Hope you well. Get your views in, Mick. What would you like to ask Neil Danns? Let's get on to things as quickly as we can. Let's bring Jamie in from the Foxes Arms to introduce Neil Danns. Hi, Jamie.
Evening all. How the devil are we? Are we all good? Hope everyone's well on this Monday evening.
Super good, Jamie. Come on, then. Let's introduce Neil Danns.
Neil Danns, you've took me link already. I was going to start with a song, singing the song, but you've took that one already.
Well, let's see you sing it, then. Now. Come on, then.
Now, everybody dance now. Well, anyway, right.
We'll see if we can get Neil Danns to sing that in a minute.
Yeah. It was one of Sven's first signings in the summer of July of 2011. He was only here for 2 years. He only really had one full season with us. And then the next season, he had two loans. He went out on loan twice. I think, if I remember rightly, it was from that video clip you just showed, he was like a real energetic player. He had a bit of misfortune to be sent off on his debut in a friendly against Mallorca. After that, it just went, I think he went well from the first year, and then the second year, a new manager, and I think things changed. So I think we ought to get him in. And he played 42 games for us, and he scored 6 goals.
A big fan's favourite at the time, so let's bring him in.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Here is Danzy, Neil Danns, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. Thanks for having me.
Brilliant, thanks
Neil, you're
for
right.
joining us.
I'm good, thanks.
Cool then, Jamie, you fire away with the first question.
The first question is, right, you were at Palace. You had a good time at Birmingham before in a Palace. How did Sven get you to leave Palace and come to Leicester? What was his influence on you for him to come to Leicester?
I think you didn't really need to, you didn't have to influence me too much, because you could just see from the outside the sort of plans that Leicester had. Obviously, you could see signings coming in from everywhere, and I think that we were really going to have a go. And of course, it was closer to home for me. I'm from Liverpool, so Leicester's not as bad as Leicester Palace was. So there was loads of factors, but the main one was just that the club looked to be going in the right direction, and the new owners were coming in, and you only have to look at the team by hours, convinced.
That's good, yeah. Good answer,
Absolutely.
That was, wasn't it?
Neil, we've got fans coming in. I've just got Tom's joined us. Tom, you got a question for Neil, Danns?
Yeah, I was going to say, just you answered the thing. I mean, that season you came in, you mentioned about the signing. I remember the first game away at Coventry, we took 5,500 fans up that day, and your reaction when we scored was priceless from the goal. I mean, that team, Gelson Fernandez, Richie Wellens, Nugent had come into the team, Schmeichel had signed. Did you really feel that that was a season we could push on as a club when you came in, and the chance was there to promotion? And why didn't you think it worked out as it did?
Yeah, definitely. When I signed, I thought we definitely had a massive chance. But that was an experience where I learned a lot from. I think putting so many players together at once, I think it was probably a bit naive to think that we could just gel together and it could just happen like that. As we all know, football, a lot of it's to do with team chemistry, figuring out what positions are best for each player and stuff. And there was a lot of us that came in the summer. I think there was like 12 or 13 players. And I think that was probably too much at the time for the team to gel together. And I think, obviously, you've seen the best of it the following years. Obviously, once the team got settled and people figured out who was best playing where and stuff like that. So you look back at it, and I think the signings set up the club in good stead for the future and what happened after that. So I think you just look back at it as a positive, even though that season didn't happen the way everyone wanted it to. I think the foundations were there. Sorry, my telly's just come on.
go and turn your telly off. Come on.
Live streaming, that, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Live stream. Big chappy in here, wonder where he's gone.
Sorry. You turned the telly off there, Neil.
Yeah.
So you were starting to say there, Neil, about building the foundations, and it very much, I think, was part of that evolution that was going on at Leicester when you came in. Did you feel like you were building into something that was going to be a much bigger picture, maybe?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, the owners hadn't been there too long. They, like everyone else, hoping that we could be promoted that season. We all know in football it will take time, and thankfully it didn't actually take that much time for Leicester once the spending and stuff did happen. So I think you look back, and I look back at it and think, well, I was a part of something that was the beginnings of Leicester getting back in the Premiership, and I got the opportunity to play with some fantastic players and players that are still there to this day. So I just look back fondly.
I saw you picked the other day, I think it was on TalkSport or somewhere, your top players you'd ever played with, Neil. It was quite a squad, quite a team that you'd got there with some great players, like you say, Heskey, Jamie Vardy and such like. You know, played with some great players in your career.
Yeah, I've been fortunate enough to, there was a lot of players that missed out, the likes of Damien Duff, Andy Cole, Dwight York. All players that I'd shared the pitch with as well. So there was a lot of competition in there, but I had to pick the team based on balance and stuff like that as well. It wasn't just as simple as that. But no, like I say, I'm fortunate enough to have played with them great players. And when I look back at my career now, I'm 37 years old and still playing in League One, do you know what I mean? So I look back now and I just think a little lad from Toxteth, got to play with some of the greatest players that have ever graced the Premiership.
Absolutely. I'm going to bring in Lee Chapman. Chappers, how are you?
Evening, guys. How are you all?
Good. Have you got a question for Neil?
I've not got a question, but I have got a comment that Neil will like. It's from Alan Young. Alan Young's watching and he says, hello. I'm sure you know Alan Young, Youngie, Leicester legend.
Yes, of course. Yeah. Absolute legend.
he's in the comment section right now, Phil. So that's quite cool. Get your comments in, guys, that are watching. So who was the best? Andy Meadow says, who's the best player that you played with at Leicester, Neil?
At Leicester, like you say, some fantastic players. But I think if you look now, you only have to look at what Jamie Vardy's gone on to do since signing for the club. And I was really close with Jamie when we was at our time at Leicester. And from the first day when I seen him come into training, straight away, you could see that he was just natural talent. I was looking, thinking, how's he been? We just signed him from non-league, because you could see the speed, you could see the technical ability instantly. And it just didn't surprise me that we paid such a hefty fee for him, straight from the
Tom?
Yeah, no, just one question, really. I mean, your time seemed to end quite quickly, suddenly. I'm just a big fan of yours, your work rate and everything like that. Your feet for, you know, you're really quick-footed around players at times, we've seen from the montage at the beginning. What actually happened with you and Nigel Pearson? I have the question, because there is rumours something happened and you suddenly disappeared out of the team and loaned out. I mean, you were in and around the team for the first year and a half and it all then just sadly disappeared.
I was actually speaking to Nigel Pearson a couple of months back, because obviously we knocked them out of the cup, the FA Cup, we beat Watford a couple of months ago, and speaking to him, but actually nothing ever happened between Nigel Pearson, and if I'm being completely honest, like I said, I'm open to any questions and stuff. I honestly don't know myself, because obviously the first season I played majority, I think I played about 30 odd games, scored 6 goals. Ended up wearing the captain's armband until the end of the season, and then I think I'd captained the team like 10 times and stuff, and obviously scored 6 goals in 30, so I thought, not a bad start to the season if I could get 10 goals next season. And then we came back to pre-season and I never ever started another Leicester game.
It's mad. So I thought you were an absolute baller when you were at Leicester. I thought, my word, we're onto something here. And then it just fizzled out. What was the difference between playing under Sven and Pearson?
Pearson was a lot more hands-on. He's a big character, tough character. Sven was the opposite. He was more laid back. Had coaches around him that did the coaching and stuff like that. And Nigel had tried to sign me a Hull from Palace before I come. On the first day that he came to Leicester, he actually said to me, you ain't playing for me. You turned me down once, show me. And then he ended up making me captain towards the end of the season. And I actually spoke to him in the second season. I went into him and said, what's happening? Mate, you've gone from making me captain, scoring 6 goals, feeling like I did pretty well, considering. And he said, do you know what, Danz? He said, it's nothing against you whatsoever. He said, you know, I love the type of player you are. But obviously with the spending that's happened, there's going to have to be some sacrifices, which was fair enough. And at the end of the day, I think I can say it now. I think I was on a good contract out there. I came from Crystal Palace on a free transfer. I was on a good contract. Probably, if I'm being honest, probably more than what an average championship player was. So I think when you look at that, he's probably thinking, well, if I can replace Dan, get 2 players in for the price of 1, then, and for me, when I look back now, and I never had a problem with Nigel or anyone, because that's the sort of person I am, I just thought to myself, well, fair enough, that's what he's there to do. If I was ever a manager, sometimes you don't like making decisions, but like being a footballer, you've got to do what's best for you. And he's in the same position, but just as a manager. So I have no problem with that whatsoever. And he was never any falling out. And even when I left on loan, Leicester played against Huddersfield and I was still signed to Leicester, but I couldn't play in the game. And I went up and spoke to him in the tunnel. And like I say, the sort of person that I am, I don't hold any grudges towards anyone or anything. And even clubs that I haven't played at, I just think it's part of the game. At the end of the day, we're blessed to do what we do. There's no point in moaning because someone has a different opinion. At the end of the day, that's football.
Neil, I've got a question from Carl Goodwin, who's watching, and he says, what was your best and worst moment while you were at Leicester? Did you hear that, Neil? Can you hear me, Neil? What was your best and worst moment at Leicester? I'm not sure. Can anybody hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you, Phil. I'll ask him. Yeah. I'll ask you. Neil? I think he's gone.
Hi, Neil. Can you hear us still? Can you hear us, Neil? I don't know if we've lost him.
I don't know. Annie Medhurst has put biggest joker in the Leicester dressing room. I really want to know who was the biggest joker
best
in the Leicester
room. Worst moment. Can you still hear me, guys?
Yeah, carry on.
For it, mate.
Yeah, I heard it, but it's a bit slow, so.
Yeah, so what was your best and worst moment at Leicester?
Best moment was...
Go on.
I think it's got a bit stuck.
Can you hear me, guys?
Yes, mate, can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. You carry on, Neil.
You might have to drop him out and drop him back and pull him back in, Phil.
We can hear you perfectly, Neil. Can you just...
Yeah, but he's behind us, isn't he? He's behind us.
Let's see. Well, while we just hopefully Neil's going to drop in and drop back out. He was a big fan's favourite, wasn't he?
He was.
Oh, like I said, he came to football club. I think when we signed him, a lot of Leicester fans were impressed with getting some of Neil Dan's quality, and he's what we needed in theory. We need someone who's a ball-winning midfielder, but also got that little bit of skill because still at time to move the ball around the park. And when he came to the football club, especially getting him in front of Rangers at the time, who were after him as well, was a big coup.
I'm trying to add Neil Dan's back in now. Ross and Jamie have joined us as well. Neil, can you hear us again?
Yeah, I can hear you now.
Brilliant. Neil, the question was from Carl, what was your best and worst moment at Leicester?
Best moment, I don't know, the great moment when we knocked Norwich out the FA Cup. They were in the Premiership at the time and we put in a really good performance. I think after that game we got to play Chelsea away. In the FA Cup, and obviously scoring against Derby, which was always an
idea.
Scoring against Derby and doing the double over them that season was really good. I'd say the worst moment was probably how it all ended, really, just that there was no real clear indication of what I still to this day, like I said, I know that decisions had to be made and stuff, but I just felt obviously after playing the majority of the games, scoring 6 goals and getting to captain the side, maybe a lot more of a chance. But in hindsight, if I would have stayed, Leicester might probably wouldn't be in the Premiership.
You don't know that. Oh dear.
We've added Ross in. Ross, have you got any questions for Neil?
Yes, I have got one actually. Can you hear me, Neil? All right.
Yep,
sound. So if you remember back in 2010, before you joined Leicester, you made a certain music video.
Yeah.
Can you remember what it was?
2010. Would that have been key?
It might be this one. I've got it on my phone. Just 2 seconds.
Don't know about this.
I've got the video at the end, Neil, so don't worry. We've got the video at the end.
Yeah, keep your head up. I remember it recently, and when I found out you were coming on, and I thought, I remember that song. 9 years ago it came out. You brought it out. Do you still do music?
Yeah, obviously when I look back at that sort of thing, now I cringe. I didn't have a clue what I was doing, but since then I've actually I've done a diploma in audio engineering and music production. I think anyone who follows me on Instagram and stuff will have seen little bits and bobs that I've been doing and stuff, and I've actually just wrote and produced a song for a lady who's being signed to a major label in the United States, which was an absolute like dream of mine, just for someone of that caliber to actually like the songs they write. Because I've never wanted to be an actual artist myself, but I play piano and guitar and stuff like that. So I've always just loved to write and stuff. And like I say, to have someone from the United States who's rich, she's a 17-year-old and she's just literally singing for Interscope Records at the minute. So I've done two songs for her. I've come back for another one. So, yeah.
Oh, nice one. The other one as well. Do you remember Spitter Too?
Yeah.
Made your own social media. Yeah, I remember. Because you were trying to be like something better than Twitter, and then it came Spitter Too or something. I remember you were talking about it on Football Focus once, and then about the radio.
Yeah, do you know what? It was doing pretty well as well. But when I got in with some other lads as well, we got the app created, and then it was sort of grown quicker than we could actually handle, because it like when you're obviously setting up things that are growing that fast, there's a lot of finances involved in taking it to the next level constantly. And like I say, it actually did well. And then it just got to that point where we were like, what do we do? Should we sell a domain and sell a thing? And then in the end, we decided to sell, so which wasn't too bad, and ended up doing okay. But like I say, probably we were too young to ever have anything like that, and it was probably too advanced for us.
Neil, I've got a question for you. Do you still keep in touch with any of the Leicester lads that you played with at the time, your spell at Leicester?
Yeah, obviously I'm older now. I've got three kids and that, so it's not that sort of touch. But I do fire over the odd message and saying we all follow each other and stuff on Twitter and Instagram, so we'll congratulate each other and stuff like that. Sent obviously all the boys that were there when I was there when Leicester won the Premier League. Sent everyone a congratulations, and like I say, from the outside it was unbelievable to watch. I was cheering myself, because you form great relationships there, and inevitably you want everyone to do well. And like I said, I've got nothing but admiration for Leicester City Football Club and everything that it's gone through in the last couple of years. I just think it's an absolutely fantastic club. Didn't work out the way I wanted it to, but I've still got so much admiration for the fans and for the actual club itself. And
brilliant.
Jamie, have you got a question?
I've got Well, it's actually a fan's question from Ben Waisley. He says, Neil, who was the best and worst trainers at the time at the club when you were there?
Best and worst trainers? That's a tough one.
I mean, we saw at the start the clip of you, Neil, enjoying training and larking around. Was that something that happened a lot?
Yeah, definitely. I think as you'll probably see now, I'm always laughing and joking, I just think life's too short. You may as well just laugh all the time. Do you know what I mean? When I look back, I can't actually pinpoint, because to be fair, we had a good group and everyone was really good trainers. Sat. But I'd say Andy Knockhart was quality, because he's obviously he was a little magician. Do you know what I mean? So you could see like. You got to see some stuff that you just think, wow, how's he just done that? And worst, do you know what? There was actually no one there that was bad I can remember, but
too many people watching, to say.
Neil, you're still playing, Neil. Talk us through, Neil, what you're doing at Tranmere and what the plans are going forward. Have you got another couple of seasons left in you?
I'm 37 years of age now, 38 in November, and genetically I've been lucky. Do you know what I mean? Plus it helps the fact that I absolutely love the game of football, and I've always loved the game of football. So now that I've got two young boys and a little girl, and my two young boys love football. One's 10 and one's 14. One actually played for Liverpool, the 14-year-old. So he's constantly got me in the garden, keeping me on my toes. So, do you know what I mean? And it's actually getting to that stage now where you start thinking, always get to be a better midfielder. I mean, yeah, that's the way it is. Like, it makes me smile every day. So, like I say, I'm fortunate and blessed to still be playing at League One at this level, and obviously got promoted last season and captained Bury to promotion. Fantastic club. Absolutely so sad of what happened to the club and stuff. But no, you just got to keep being positive and keep enjoying every day. And that's what I do now, because I know it doesn't last forever. So I just try and take one season at a time. And as long as I can do a job for someone, I'll play as long as I possibly can.
Tom, have you got a question there?
Yeah, he just sort of answered it, really. I mean, you captained Bury to League One promotion. What was fair play, brilliant to the club. And it's such a tragic thing to see a football club to go under like it did. Do you think things need to be put in place? This doesn't happen again to any other football club, because it just seems like to me the Football League didn't want to help Bury out and just let it happen.
Yeah, 100%. I think a lot of questions got asked when all the situation happened, and I think it was vital that questions got asked how certain owners were allowed to take over football clubs without proof of actual funds and buying clubs for £1 and then never paying the players once. And like I say, my hat goes off to all the lads who were there at Bury, because we literally had to, we got promoted without being paid for 7 months. And I know in the lower leagues it was hard watching, because some of them lads haven't been fortunate enough to play at high levels and have savings and stuff. So you've really seen people struggling, and you see the kit woman crying and stuff like that. And it was really a disaster. And one thing that I hope no other club has to experience, because it does really affect people's lives.
Are you, Neil, are you still in the international side as well? Because you've got a couple of goals, haven't you, under your wing at international level?
I was fortunate enough, the first ever time in the country's history to qualify for the Gold Cup, obviously with the likes of Mexico, USA, where we qualified, and I'd scored in every qualifier to get us there. And then obviously we went to the Gold Cup. We had Panama, USA and Trinidad in our group. We ended up finishing third, and we were the smallest country there. I ended up scoring 3 goals in 3 games. I scored 2 against Panama and got selected in the
top man.
Best 11 of this one.
Neil, I've got one here from a Tranmere fan. We've got a Tranmere fan watching it as well. Wow. And he says, could you say hi to John Blundell, who's watching?
Hello, John, mate. Hope you're well.
So they're all everywhere. Who's got one final question out of our guys?
I have. Mine's gonna be very quick.
Go on.
Go on
when
then,
you were
Jay,
there,
mate.
Who was the fastest? You or Lloyd Dyer? Who was the fastest?
Lloyd Dyer. I'm not quick. I just knew how to look, how to pretend to look quick.
Yes, you did look quick.
You did.
You did look quick.
You did. You looked really quick.
Yeah, that's why I grew my hair, so it shakes around and it just gives that illusion.
Phil, I think we should wrap it up with, Dan's is a, you're a Liverpool fan, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, so talk Boy to me, how do you want the season to finish? We finished this show on the same questions. How's the season finishing?
For me, do you know what? In my head, I don't care what anyone says. We won the league anyway, regardless. In all seriousness, I just think it should finish whatever way is best for the general public. At the end of the day, we're in a serious situation now, and I'm like a football fan as well. I do want this season. If there is a way that I can do that, then questions. Yep. Because like I say, the main themselves, all the world, everyone watching is
brilliant. Okay, I think Neil, that's been absolutely fantastic having you with us tonight, Neil. Thanks so much for joining us.
Does he know his song though? Can he sing his song?
Can you sing his song at the end?
The chance.
Come on, we're going to do it, Neil. Are you going to join us?
Everybody dance now.
Did you get, Neil, have you had that everywhere, at every club you've been to, or was it just Leicester?
No, I did. I used to actually sing at Crystal Palace as well. And then obviously, if you look on my Twitter, I've got the stuff with the Leicester with it. So, do you know what? I'm thankful whoever took the photo and the fan in there. If you can get in touch with me, I'll send you one of my old Leicester kits.
Fantastic, brilliant. Thanks, Neil, for joining us tonight. It's been an absolute pleasure.
Cheers, Neil. Thank you. Brilliant.
Cheers, Neil. Thank you, mate.
Good luck at Tranmere for the end of the season as well, Neil.
I appreciate that, guys. Thanks for having me.
Oh, no problem. Thank you.
Care, I've enjoyed having you on, mate. It's been brilliant. Thank you.
Everybody dance.
Thanks, Neil. That's been superb. Thanks so much for Neil joining us. Thanks, Russ, as well, for joining us. You got your questions in there. Thank you for that.
Yes, well.
See you soon, Russ. Who else have we got? Chappers.
Yes.
Thursday.
Go on then.
We have got.
I've lost
Richard
track.
Stearman. No, it's Thursday, Phil. It's Monday tonight. We have got Richard Stearman on Thursday. He's still playing at Huddersfield. So we've actually got so that's Neil Danns still playing at Tranmere and Richard Stearman still playing at Huddersfield on Thursday night at 7 o'clock.
I know what I want to ask Richard Stearman about. Stoke away.
Oh, no. We have to bring that one up.
I will. Do you know what? Because Richard Stearman, he's up there in my estimations, right at the top. Because I swear to God, he was about one of the only players who was bothered that day.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right there.
He really was bothered about it, and you could see it. So I'm really pleased we've got him on. I think he'll be a good chat. And like you say, still playing out. He's had a great career, actually, after leaving Leicester. Very steady. He's been at Wolves as well, hasn't he? And
Sheffield United,
Wolves, Ipswich, Wolves.
Promotions.
Yeah, loads of blades, promotions.
I think he played in Europe as well for Wolves, didn't he?
I think he's done very well. Right, anyway, listen, guys. Thanks, everybody. Thanks, Tom, for joining us. Are you getting any sleep yet, Tom?
No.
Go and have a rest. Thanks, Tom, for joining us.
Brilliant.
Thanks, Chappers.
Thanks for having me on again. I'll see you Thursday evening, Phil. And J-Met, see you later. Take care.
See you later.
Thanks. And thanks, Jamie, for fixing that one up again.
Not a problem. They're still coming in. They're all coming in still. They all want to chat to us.
Brilliant. Right. Let's see.
See you later. See you Thursday.
See you soon, Jamie. Let's get a few comments in there from people who have been watching. Thanks, everybody, for getting all your comments in, as ever. Thanks for Neil Danns for joining us. Thanks, as ever, for the guys, the sponsors. You know who they are because we keep plugging them. But thanks as well to all those guys. And, of course, mostly thanks to Neil Danns for joining us. That's been the absolute biggest one. So thanks, everybody, for watching. If you can like and share this video, I'd appreciate it. My name's Phil. This is Leicester Fan TV. Cheers.